mistake. 67 to 69 fastback. Custom paint, Roush racing engine. All these cars are show cars.
Beautiful. This is 427 cubic inches. So this would perform way better than it did back in the day.
Sometimes driving the cars that are the slowest can be fun. When we were younger, we always had dune buggies and stuff. But this is a custom, probably airbags and stuff. Beautiful paint job on it, but he lowered it. You can tell where he was riding, the tire was rubbing the fender.
Builds up heat. Showing all the hydraulics and stuff. So what I never really liked the idea of is when you drop these cars with independent suspension, and they drop so low, the wheels kick in up on top.
Sun Coupe. Never saw that kind of a top back in 1969 or 70. When I was growing up, this is the kind of cars you'd see at the drag strip. When they did 10 seconds and they were doing wheelies going through the gears, it was really impressive. Now they do 6 seconds and they either take off or they just spin and then they quit. Time you see an import car and you think, oh, what's this gonna do? It slammed me back in the chair. And I thought it was really cool. It just doesn't sound like a V8. But when you see guys, you know, I think a body shop do this kind of conversion for the doors, it's a big ass plate bolts up there. I think it's just adding a bunch of weight. But they like the looks of it. So here in Milwaukee, you got big potholes. So if you don't want to get sucked up into a pothole, you got to get bigger wheels.
Well, usually when kids get involved in the lowrider scene, their dad helps them out, and they're out in the garage, and they're learning how to use wrenches and stuff. It's a work of art.
Customizing.
So when you see these types of cars, their blood, sweat, and tears, and their life is devoted to these cars. They're every penny. Everything's chrome underneath. The custom paint is just outrageous. All the hydraulics. Everything on it is perfect. I've had a couple of these. He's always bragging about how fast they're going. Oh, it's only like about a 14-second car. He's bullshit. If I put a chip in it, it'll do 10 seconds. You know, good luck with that. I still like the way they look.
Man, it's perfect paint on this.
A lot of these things are really beat up if you ever see them. They've been used.
People that like this T-Don look, or just getting a car right out of the barn and fixing it up, they got rust holes and everything. I could never do that. I gotta at least have the rust holes patched, I gotta have it at least flat black. 71 Plymouth Cuda is my favorite. And I always like this strobe stripe, I think it's really cool. Mopar always had a lot of aggressive looks on their cars. Gassers back in the old days. It's called a Henry J. But they were sold by Sears and Roebuck. And they were really an inexpensive car. Some of them didn't even have a trunk in the back. It's just really a light car. And they use them for racing. They're kind of cool. This is my favorite 69 Camaro with the RS package and their Hideaway headlights. It's got ghosted stripes. It's a 498. Paint job's beautiful. It's tubbed out. Huge tires in the back. You can see all the nitrous. Roll cage, nice interior. Friend had one of these back in the day, and he got an engine from Sox and Martin, and he had the big, heavy cast iron four-speed Dana 60 with big slicks for like 10 seconds. The CT70. Man, I would have given my left nut for something like this. But I had this really Femi one with the step through frame. And moved up the gas tank. This is like a powerhouse compared to a 50. Change the attitude of that car. Two turbos. you know, I was just getting into it and I had a shovel head. Well, shovel heads were cheap. They only had one screw that held the pipes on. These had a band clamp on. Sometimes they'd all be blasting away and all of a sudden somebody would be ding, 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 ding. You know, the pipe would fall off because the more gas you're giving it, the more pressure the pipe would fall off. But it's still connected down there, so sparks would be coming off and we'd have to stop and it's hot and trying to put it back down. This is my wife has to ride on something like that.
You got to pucker your butt cheeks together. What do they call it, an axe handle?
The axe handle when they get really wide. And then they go, hey, it looks like Paul got some new saddlebags.